HubSpot Lifecycle Stages. HubSpot Lifecycle Stages help keep your customer relationship management CRM database properly segmented so that you can confidently send the right emails to the right person at the right time. In this video, you're going to learn why HubSpot Lifecycle Stage contact property plays such an important role in healthy customer relationship management, how to use the lifecycle stage to protect the customer experience, CX, and what lifecycle stage contact properties look like. Before we get into that, please be sure to click the subscribe button and ring the bell on this YouTube channel so that you can be notified when new videos like this get published. Have you ever worried that you'll accidentally offend a customer by sending a prospect-related email? Has someone from your company ever accidentally sent customer-only insider information to prospects? If so, HubSpot Lifecycle Stages can help, and if your sales, marketing, and customer success teams ever make the mistake of simultaneously emailing the same contacts, burning goodwill, and making your company look somewhere between overzealous and incompetent, you need Lifecycle Stages. HubSpot defines the lifecycle stage as a property that enables your team to determine where a specific contact is in your processes and better understand how leads are handed off between marketing and sales. Since it can sometimes be confusing, let's clarify that lifecycle stage actually differs from buyer's journey stage. The buyer's journey is the active research process that a person goes through between when that person identifies a problem to solve, a goal to achieve, or a question to answer, and when that person ultimately makes a purchase decision. The buyer's journey consists of three stages: awareness, consideration, and decision. The buyer's journey tends to be customer-centric. The three stages of the buyer's journey address how your ideal customers navigate their journey with your company. The lifecycle stage, on the other hand, is all about how your company classifies a particular contact based on the nature of their relationship with your company. Most customer relationship management CRM systems categorize individual contacts as one of several lifecycle stages. The lifecycle stage includes eight possible stages or contact properties: 1, subscriber; 2, lead; 3, marketing qualified lead, MQL; 4, sales qualified lead, SQL, also sometimes known as SAL, sales accepted lead; 5, opportunity; 6, customer; 7, evangelist; 8, other. Within most tech startups, the marketing team owns contacts in the subscriber and lead lifecycle stages. The sales team owns contacts in the marketing qualified lead, MQL, sales qualified lead, SQL, and opportunity stages. And the customer success team owns contacts in the customer and evangelist stages. From a practical standpoint, what does this mean? When the marketing team promotes an upcoming webinar for prospects, those emails should only go to contacts with a subscriber or lead lifecycle stage. The sales team should only communicate with contacts in the marketing qualified lead, MQL, sales qualified lead, SQL, and opportunity stages. And the customer success team should only communicate with contacts in the customer or evangelist lifecycle stage. How does your company use the HubSpot Lifecycle Stage contact property to manage the marketing to sales handoff and sales to customer success handoff? And how does the lifecycle stage help you protect the customer experience, CX? Let me know in the comments section down there below. Do you know someone else who could also benefit from this video on HubSpot Lifecycle Stages? Be sure to share this with them as well. And if you're serious about HubSpot Lifecycle Stages, learn more when you enroll now in our free 7-day e-course, Go-to-Market Strategy 101 for B2B SaaS Startups and Scale-Ups, at gotomarket101.com. Again, that URL is gotomarket101.com.